how do I get my hands on more income? How do I monetize?
Welcome to Hobby Meets Hustle, the show that pairs young professionals with business experts to help them turn their passion into profit.
Yes.
Meet Luis Octavio, a 40-year-old creator and master of DIY a la Mexicana. Luis will hear advice from our panel of experts, Nikki, TurboTax expert, Brittany, financial expert, and Ashley, side hustle consultant.
One of those ideas that I had was to do a raffle.
Raffling is actually considered gambling.
He'll then select one expert to be his mentor. Who will Luis pick?
I think I really want to work with.
Find out now on Hobby Meets Hustle.
Nice to meet you. Hola, my name is Luis Octavio, and I am the person behind these DIYs that you see here, or as I like to say, DIY. It's about taking regular household items like you see here, these bottles, giving them a new life, repurposing them, but repurposing them with my cultura behind them.
Fantastic. You have an amazing energy.
I've been doing these things since I was like 17 years old. I never put any of my creations on any social media platform. And I thought, listen, if I put these things out, I think it's gonna be a dead giveaway that I am queer. So it wasn't until this year that I decided to try out TikTok. And now I have 24,000 followers. So here, I brought some of my most popular TikToks, the mirror over there with Frida, then like this chair here. And that is what DIY is all about.
Amazing.
What a story.
Yeah, that's incredible. You're a true artist.
Gracias, thank you.
What would you say are some of your pressing challenges?
Right now, the goal is how can I create from hobby to a side hustle and potentially getting it to be a business?
You have a lot of inventory? Just curious.
I don't have a lot of inventory.
Putting a price on this, it's so subjective. I recognize it's very difficult to identify a number.
People have asked, hey, I'm interested in buying these, but then I run into the problem of how do I price this out? How do I monetize? One of those ideas that I had was to do a raffle. How do I set tax things aside? What do I do?
Raffling is actually considered gambling.
I don't want to do anything that's obviously not legal.
You have to be very careful. I can definitely help you figure this out. So now the question is, who do you choose as your mentor?
So if you select me as your mentor, I will help you put a formula together to help you kind of get to that next level.
If you select me as your mentor, we'll work on how to monetize this, how to set a price, or we can explore other options.
And if you select me as your mentor, I would just help you get more organized with the business financial plan and how that could relate to your personal financial plan so it does become a profitable business for you.
Gracias.
Who will you choose as your mentor?
I think I really want to work with Nikki. If you could help me get that off the ground, I'd be very, very happy.
Awesome, I'd be honored to help you.
What I need the most is to be able to continue to grow and not bump into any legality issues. I think my most pressing right now is the expenses because I want to be able to know what can I expend.
Tell me this, how do you have your expenses organized? Like, how do you know what you spend?
I mean, I basically have an Excel sheet and whenever I remember, I'll put in there like spray paint for XYZ project, but I haven't been saving any of the receipts or anything like that.
Have you thought about isolating your expenses in a separate account or with a separate card?
I never thought about that, but I can see why that would be so much easier. How do I decide what I expense on that card?
As a business owner, you are entitled to report and deduct all of your expenses on your tax return. When you go and you shop for paint and furniture and all of these are reportable expenses. If you have a home office, for example, you have a spot in your garage, you can take a portion of your rent or a portion of your mortgage payment and you can deduct that. As
oh my
a business
God, I never
expense.
Even thought about that. And yeah, that's why I'm doing all my DIYs in the garage.
That's your office.
Yeah.
Let's cover how your bringing in your revenue. I think you mentioned raffling as an idea. Raffles aren't off the table. Uh-huh. The one thing that makes it gambling is the money component. In order for participants to have a ticket or a spot in the raffle, it has to be no purchase necessary. If you're not sure of how to price your items, you can host an auction.
As you're mentioning that, my wheels are spinning and I'm thinking, okay, maybe I could do a live, and I think my followers would probably appreciate that.
And then finally, we talked about you and your products. You have such a wide array of products. So I would really encourage you to focus and hone in on a singular area, and that will give you much better pathway for success.
Oh my God, that's so difficult to focus on just one, but I will try.
Luis, I have some exciting news for you. To help you reach your business goals, Intuit is gifting you with 3 years of TurboTax Live.
Oh my God.
That means that you have access to tax experts to guide you through this. You have 1 year of access to QuickBooks Online, so you can organize your accounting, and MailChimp.
Oh my God, that's so exciting, because I was already sweating it. Like, who's gonna help me with this? So that's great. I love that. Gracias.
Also, we're going to give you a small gift fund to help finance some of your projects and get you off the ground.
That is so awesome. Can I get a hug? I want to give you a hug because that's so awesome. Muchas gracias. The fact that these experts are here giving us advice is amazing. What I would say to anybody that has a hobby right now that thinks could potentially be a side hustle is just try it.